हेलो क्लास सेवन, हियर वी आर प्रेजेंटिंग वीडियो क्लासेस फॉर मैथमेटिक्स। हियर योर फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज इंटीजर एंड नाउ द फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ योर चैप्टर इज नेचुरल नंबर। हियर इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ नेचुरल नंबर। ऑल काउंटिंग नंबर्स आर कॉल्ड नेचुरल नंबर्स। ऑल काउंटिंग नंबर्स आर कॉल्ड नेचुरल नंबर। काउंटिंग नंबर मीन्स 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 एंड द सेट ऑफ कलेक्शन ऑफ नेचुरल नंबर इज डिनोटेड बाय कैपिटल एन। कैपिटल एन इज स्टैंड फॉर फर्स्ट वर्ड ऑफ द नेचुरल। सो नेचुरल नंबर, दिस इज द सेट ऑफ नेचुरल नंबर, कैपिटल एन इज इक्वल टू 1, 2, 3, 4 एंड सो ऑन। नाउ द नेक्स्ट नंबर, होल नंबर्स। हियर द डेफिनेशन ऑफ होल नंबर्स, ऑल नेचुरल नंबर्स टुगेदर विद जीरो आर कॉल्ड होल नंबर्स। ऑल नेचुरल नंबर्स टुगेदर विद जीरो आर कॉल्ड होल नंबर्स एंड द सेट ऑफ कलेक्शन ऑफ होल नंबर्स इज डिनोटेड बाय कैपिटल डब्ल्यू एंड कैपिटल डब्ल्यू इज स्टैंड फॉर फर्स्ट वर्ड ऑफ द होल। So capital W is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, and they are the whole numbers. Now integer, what are the integers? Here is the definition of integers. All natural numbers, they are negatives along with 0 are called integers. Here integers, all natural numbers, they are negatives along with 0 are called integer, and the set of collection of integer is represented by capital Z. Capital Z is comes from a German word Zahlen. Zahlen means to count. So the set of integer is denoted by capital Z. Now some properties are the integer. There are some various type of the integer. First, positive integers means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So all natural numbers are called positive integers. And their negative, all negative natural numbers are called negative integers. So 0 is neither positive nor negative. So there are three types of integers: positive integers, negative integers, and zero. Zero is neither positive nor negative. Now, the next topic is addition of integers. Now, here some examples of addition of integers. Here 15 plus 30, both are positive integers. 15 and 13, both are positive integers. So, when we add two positive integers, plus 15 and plus 13. Now, add these integers, 5 plus 3, 8, 1 plus 1, 2. Both are the positive integers, so the sum of these integers is also a positive integer. Now, if both are negative integers, minus 15 and minus 12, then we add these two integers, 5 plus 2, 7, 1 plus 1, 2, minus 27. That means when the both integers having same sign, both are either positive or both negative, then we add the integers. Look at in this integers, both are positive, so we add and the result will be also positive. In these integers, both are negative, so again we add these integers and the sign of their sum will also are negative. So if the both integers having same signs, either positive or both having negative, we add these two integers with their sign. Now subtraction of integer, when two integers having different signs, if one integer is positive, second is negative, either first is positive, second is negative. In these conditions, we subtract the integers. We subtract the lower integer by the upper integer. Here 50 minus 12. 15 is positive, 12 is negative. Then these integers have a different sign. This is the positive and this is negative. So subtract these integers. When the signs are different, then we subtract the integers. 5 minus 2, 3, 1 minus 1, 0. What is the result? 3. But the sign of the result, the sign of the result having a greater, if the greater integer having positive sign, the result will be also positive. If in the second example, here 13 minus 18, 13 is positive integer, 18 is negative, then we have to subtract these two. Now, but we subtract the lower integer by the upper integer. So here we subtract 13 from 18. We subtract 13 from 18. Here, when we subtract 13 from 18, 8 minus 3, 5, 1 minus 1, 0. But sign of the result having the greater integer, what is the greater integer? Greater integer is the 18, and 18 having negative sign. So result will be also negative. Okay. Now the next topic is properties of addition of integer. There are some properties of integer. The first property is the closure property. The closure property means the sum of two integers is always an integer. When we add two integers, then the when we add two integers, the sum is always an integer. For example, suppose 5 and 3, these are two integers. When we add these two integers, 5 plus 3, 8, 8 is also an integer. Here 4 and minus 6, 4 and minus 6 are two integers. When we add 4 and minus 6, we get minus 2, and minus 2 is and also an integer. So this is the closure property. When 10 minus 5, two integers, when we add two integers, 10 and minus 5, we get 5, and 5 is also an integer. And so the sum of two integers is always an integer. So the addition of integers follow the closure property. Now the second property, commutative law of addition. Commutative means when we change the order of integer. When we change the order of integer, the result will be same. Now, consider A and B are two integers. When we add A plus B and change the order, add B and A, the result will be same in both conditions. For example, 7 and 3. 7 and 3 are two integers. When we add 7 by 3, 7 plus 3 is equal to 10. When we change the order, first write 3 and then 7. 3 plus 7 is also 10. So the order, when we change the order, the result will be the same. A plus B is equal to B plus A. And this is called the commutative law of addition of integers. Now the third property, associative law of addition. We consider three integers a b c are three integers. When we add three integers, we cannot three integers add together. We have to add two integers at a time and then we add the third one. Now the associative law is A plus B plus C is equal to A B plus C. Means when we add first two integers and then add the third integer, और वी ऐड सेकंड और थर्ड इंटीजर, देन वी ऐड फर्स्ट इंटीजर इनटू देम, द रिजल्ट विल बी सेम. नाउ फॉर एग्जांपल 3 - 5 = 8, देयर आर 3 इंटीजर. व्हेन वी ऐड फर्स्ट टू 3 - 5 एंड देन थर्ड, what will be the result? -5 + 3 = -2 and +8. 8 - 2 = 6. Now, when we change the sequence, when we add the second and the third integer first, the second and third means -5 and 8. When we add -5 + 8, 8 - 5 = +3, and the first integer is 3. 3 + 3 = 6. Means when we change the order, the result will be the same. This is called associative law of addition. Okay. Now, the next property is existence of additive identity. What is the identity? Now, when any integer is added to 0 or 0 is added to any integer, then result will not be changed. For example, when we add 0 in 5 or 5 in 0, the result is the unchanged. Means 0 is called additive identity. When something is added in any integer and result will not be changed, then it is called an additive identity. So, what is the additive identity? 0 is the additive identity. Okay? Now, existence of additive inverse. What is the additive inverse? If we consider any integer A, then its negative integer is called additive inverse. For example, if we take 8 and its negative is -8, when we add these two, we get 0. Okay? So, what it will be the additive inverse? The negative of the given integer is called additive inverse. If A is an integer, then its additive inverse is -8. Okay, if -a is an integer, then its negative means -a is the additive inverse of -a. Okay, class 7, you have made lot of mistake in sign convention of integers. As your PDF is already given, so what is the sign convention of integers? Look at -5 + 8. Here two integers, -5 and +8, both having different signs. When we get a different signs, always subtract the smaller integer by the greater one. Here the greater integer is 8, we subtract 5 from it. 8 - 5 = 3, and 3 is the positive integer. Why? Your greater integer has been positive sign. Okay? Now 7 - -5. Look at minus and minus. There are no integers between two signs. Why? Two signs is separated by a bracket. Then what will be? We get minus and minus. When we get same sign, if we get plus and plus, then your result will be plus. When we get minus and minus, your result again will be plus. Okay, so clear this sign convention. When we have same sign, either positive or negative, always we get a positive sign. When we get different signs like plus, minus or minus plus, then we always have negative sign. Okay? Why? Two signs are separated by only brackets, not by integer. Here, for example, when 5 is added by 3. 5 and 3, both are the positive integers. 5 and 3, add 5 and 3, and we will get 8. Now, if both are negative, minus 5, minus 3, then what will be the result? Minus and minus, when these two signs is separated by only brackets, not by an integer, only separated by bracket, then the result will positive. Okay, look at if minus 5 and minus 3. Look at minus and minus is separated by only bracket, not by an integer. So minus 5, minus and minus changes into plus. Now minus 5 and plus 3. Here both are different signs. So minus 5 and plus 3, when we get different signs, always we have to subtract. Subtract the smaller integer by the greater one. Subtract 3 from 5, we get 2. But the sign, the greater integer having the sign, that your region will have same sign. Here minus 5 plus 3, so your region will be minus 2. Now, what is the confusion? If minus 5 and minus 3, here two integers having same sign, minus 5 and minus 3, both are having negative sign, but there are both are having negative sign but different integers. So minus 5, minus 3, both having same signs, we have to add these two integers with their sign. Minus 5 and minus 3 is equal to minus 8, not plus 8. You have made lot of mistake in sign convention. So clear it. Now, if we add more than two integers, we have more than two integers in this question. Look at minus 10 plus 5, minus 3 plus 15. Look at the sign of the integers. 10 is negative integer, 3 is negative integer, 5 is a positive integer, and 15 is a positive integer. First, separate the positive and negative integers. Now, collect the negative integers minus 10 and minus 3 and plus 5 and plus 15. Okay. Add the integers having same signs with their sign, minus 10 and minus 3 having same sign. So add these two integers, 10 and 3 is 13, but minus 10 and minus 3, so it is minus 13. Now, plus 5 plus 15, both have been same sign, both are positive integer. So 15 plus 5 is equal to plus 20. Both are the positive integer, so the result is also positive. Both are negative, so the result is negative. Now, one having negative and another positive. Now it will be subtract. 20 minus 13. The greater integer is 20. 20 minus 13 is 7. And the greater integer having positive sign, then result is also positive. Okay? Is that clear?